Micmac Indians christened Prince Edward Island Aberystwyth, home cradled on the waves. Their god Glooskap, creating for himself a haven, seized his magic brush, dipped it in his gayest color, and so the rocks and earth of Aberystwyth are red. Modern folk now enjoy the great god's dwelling place. They come by plane flying daily from Moncton, New Brunswick, or by the ferry Aberystwyth, which is equipped to carry passengers, their autos, yes, and railway cars, as there is no bridge to the island. The ferry docks at Port Borden, main port of entry to this, the smallest province of Canada. An hour's drive takes you to Charlottetown and Provincial House. This picturesque building is the birthplace of Canada. In this room in 1864, the fathers of Confederation met. Around this table, they considered how to weld together the scattered colonies. 3 years later, Confederation was an accomplished fact. In the hearts and minds of the delegates who assembled in this room on September 1st, 1864, was born the Dominion of Canada. Providence being their guide, they builded better than they knew. Charlottetown is the capital city. It is a pleasant, home-like spot and has a fine CNR hotel, of which the islanders are justly proud. Here, a group of tourists, armed against the sea air with substantial box lunches, set off to visit Prince Edward Island National Park. Close to the capital, a little corner of the island has been set aside as a national playground. The park provides well-equipped dressing rooms and kitchen shelters for the use of daily visitors. Or you may prefer to picnic outside, cooking at the stone fireplace in one of the park picnic grounds. Headquarters of the National Park are close to Dalvey House, a comfortable summer hotel. In the park area, visitors will find a sport for every taste. Tennis? The red clay court is close to the hotel. Golf? The clubhouse at the park golf links overlooks the first tee. The links lies on Green Gables Farm, immortalized in Canadian literature by Lucy Maud Montgomery's Anne of Green Gables. The birches stand just as they did when Anne played beneath their shade. Back on the hill stands the farmhouse itself with its green-trimmed gables. Swimming? Well, just come over the dunes, and you will find some of the finest beach in America and the warmest sea bathing in eastern Canada. Brackley Beach and Cavendish Beach, beaten smooth and broad by the pounding surf, provide ideal swimming for youngsters and exciting surf bathing for the more venturesome. Miss Montgomery wrote, "We children almost lived by the shore. It was a world in itself." Have to be athletic to enjoy the beach and the sea air. It's fun just to relax. And enjoy the scenery. Would rather swim than sunbathe. The bugle rouses the lads of the Boy Scout camp for an afternoon ramble along the bluffs above the sea. Perhaps you would like to ride in the early morning. The island is famous for its purebred horses. Of course, you may think this is the finest sport of them all. And you may be right. Some like to try their luck at deep sea fishing. And have you ever been to a clam bake? It's quite an experience. First, you must find the clams. The trick in digging is to get them before they realize what's going on and sink beneath the sand. Cooking them is a real art, and of course each chef has his own particular technique. But here a low hot fire is built, a sheet of metal placed over it, the clams piled on top and covered with wet seaweed. When thoroughly steamed, the clams are ready. You do get to like them. This gal must be a clam lover from a way back. As you look back on your seaside holiday and Prince Edward Island nestled in the mighty Gulf of St. Lawrence, you will remember the words of Jacques Cartier, "The fairest land that it may be possible to see."